It's Tip Tuesday again, so I'm Megan with Rocky Mountain Sewing and Vacuum. Today we're going to go over a tip that is super simple, and so simple that we often overlook it. So, we're going to be talking about threading today, and one of the biggest tricks you can do with threading your machine to make sure that your tension is right every time. And it is basically just always make sure, no matter what machine you have, a sewing machine, a serger, an embroidery machine, a long arm, any of that, if you are able to raise and lower your presser foot, always, always, always thread your machine with the presser foot in the upright position. I like to call the tension discs almost like the symbols that a monkey carries. I always think of the one from Phantom of the Opera. But think of those symbols, and when the presser foot is in the upright position, those symbols open up. When it's down, they are slammed together super duper tight. They do that so that when your fabric is feeding through and you've got your foot all the way down, it's not going to create a bird's nest or anything like that. A lot of beginner sewers forget to put their foot down when they're sewing and then have a lot of tension problems. So when you're threading, it's also important to keep this in mind, because when it's up, those symbols are nice and open. When it's down, they are tight, tight, tight closed. So I've got two different machines here. I've got a Brother Pacesetter 500 and the Bernina L850 to kind of show you guys some things that some machines do to make you remember to do that, and then also what that actually looks like. So, on the Brother, something that's really cool about these guys is that they actually give you kind of a fail-safe to remind you to do that, and most Brothers will do this. Your tension discs are going to lie right around here. So, wherever your tension dial, most of the time, you come around the machine and your tension discs hang out right here. So, when my presser foot is down on a Brother, you'll see that there is a little plastic piece here that kind of covers it up. When I lift my presser foot, that plastic piece goes away. So anytime I lower it, it's in the way, so that when I get to number four, I go, oops, and then I can raise it, make sure everything is seated correctly, then continue to thread. So that's something that I love about Brothers. Like I said, almost the entire lineup does that, and I think it's a fantastic little reminder that they do just to make sure that you don't have any of those tension problems in the future. Now, on your other home sewing machines, they won't always have that little plastic piece, but this is still a trick that you want to do no matter what brand you have. On the Bernina serger here, I like this one because I can actually physically see all of the tension discs here. So with my presser foot down, you can see all eight of these little symbols are pressed really, really tight together. And when I raise my presser foot up, you can see them all open up nice and big, so that when I go to thread my machine, which this one is a super easy one to thread anyways, but it just makes it even better, you can just do that. It seats right in the tension disc, and then when you're ready to go, you can put the foot down, and then you're good to go, smooth sailing. So that's the tip for this week, is always, always, always make sure to thread your machine with your presser foot in the upright position. If you guys have any tips or tricks that you'd like us to share, please let us know in the comments. And if you have done this before and realized, oh no, that was a disaster, let us know. We'd love to hear it. We'll see you next week. Thank you for joining me.
Just a tip.